Tonight, an Arizona voter and his wife allegedly filmed and photographed as they tried to use a ballot drop box this week. This is according to a voter intimidation complaint, which is now in the hands of the Department of Justice. The complaint specifically says the group accused the couple of, quote, being a mule. This is important because it's a likely reference to a voter fraud conspiracy film about so-called mules who were hired to stuff drop boxes with potentially fake absentee ballots in the 2020 election. Kyung Lah is out front.
Outside the Maricopa County Elections Department, a small group of people is gathering, watching, and recording as voters return early ballots at this drop box and election workers enter and exit.
They're taking pictures of them, and regardless of what the intent is of these people who are taking pictures of our elections workers, they're harassing people, they're not helping. Further the interests of democracy.
To be clear, there's nothing illegal about standing 75 feet away from a ballot drop box on a public street. But at another drop box in Maricopa County, a voter filed this complaint that alleges a group of people filmed and photographed the voter and his wife as they tried to vote, accusing them of being a mule, taking photographs of their license plate and following them to the parking lot. The voter intimidation complaint filed with the Arizona Secretary of State, Katie Hobbs, who is also running for governor, has been referred to the Department of Justice and Arizona Attorney General's office for investigation. This complaint comes in a state that never stopped chasing conspiracies about the 2020 election. From the multi-million dollar and problem-plagued partisan review of Maricopa County's ballots, to 2022, with the rise of the Trump-backed candidates, like Republican nominee for Governor Carrie Lake. She's among a full slate of statewide candidates who have denied the truth about the 2020 election. When asked about the complaint about voter intimidation, Lake said she had not heard about it, then added this.
This is another reason we have to restore integrity. We can't have half of the population or more doubting our elections. It's not impossible to restore honesty and integrity to our elections, and I assure you when I'm governor, we will do that.
Lake says this even as there is no evidence of widespread election fraud. Joining her in sowing doubt about the election, Blake Masters, Republican U.S. Senate nominee. In the primary, Masters said this in a campaign ad.
I think Trump won in 2020.
That helped him win Trump's endorsement. In the general election, Masters has shifted his stance, saying he hadn't seen evidence it was stolen. But then, just last week at a political event, when asked about election integrity, Masters replied,
"And a lot of people saw things that they did not like in 2020, to put it mildly. And so we're going to have an army, have a lot more eyes and ears and boots on the ground this time."
You may have noticed standing next to Carrie Lake is Virginia Governor Glenn Youngkin. He is someone who won the governorship in Virginia by keeping Trump at arm's length. Lake has fully embraced Trump. So what do they have in common? They want to win. And Lake wants to stand next to a winner. It is what Tudor Dixon wants. It is why Youngkin is heading there in Michigan. But then he's heading to Georgia to campaign with Brian Kemp, who also kept Trump at a distance and has famously battled with him. Aaron, what they all have in common is they all want to win. Aaron?
Kyung, thank you very much. Interesting, the star power of someone like Carrie Lake and also Glenn Youngkin, certainly in national Republican politics. Out front now, Bakari Sellers, former Democratic member of the South Carolina House of Representatives and conservative radio host Eric Erickson, of course, the host of the Eric Erickson Show. Okay, a lot to talk about here, and I do want to ask about Glenn Youngkin, but first, Bakari. This issue with the mules accusation, this ballot drop box issue in Arizona. We're only about 2 weeks away from Election Day, 2.5. How worried are you that this is just the beginning and that things are going to get a lot nastier and uglier?
I mean, things will get a lot nastier, things will get a lot uglier, but I'm not worried. I mean, the fact is people oftentimes throughout history have had to overcome obstacles. Blake Masters and Carrie Lake have absolutely no backbone. The reason that they're very popular in MAGA land and with the Republican Party right now is that they stand for absolutely nothing. And for them to say they're patriots, or for them to say that they're pro-democracy, or for them to even say that they stand with the United States of America, it's oxymoronic to say the least. The fact is, these individuals who are running for office right now are unqualified to hold any seat. And yes, they're going to put a militia on the ground, and yes, they're going to use voter intimidation. But I really believe that voters in Arizona are willing to overcome all of those things to elect people who deserve to be in office. And Carrie Lake and Blake Masters simply are clowns who do not deserve to be in office because fundamentally they don't stand for anything. They want to do is win.
Which may be true. I mean, there's many who would say that that's what most politicians want. I guess to that point, Eric, what Carrie Lake seems to have is energy and star power. Is that enough?
She's got energy and star power, and she's also got four of the last five polls in Arizona showing her winning. She's definitely doing something right out there. Katie Hobbs' refusal to debate her just reinforces that there's something Hobbs is scared of. I wasn't a big fan of either of the Republican candidates on the ground in Arizona in the primary, but Carrie Lake has shown herself to be a very adept politician with years of media training being in the media, and it's certainly working to her advantage.
So, Bakar, I want to ask you about what he just mentioned, though. Eric just mentioned the debate, the lack thereof, right? Katie Hobbs, right at the original part, when she started running, was hailed as a hero by Democrats across the country because she stood up to Trump's efforts to overturn the election, right? She counted the ballots fairly in the state of Arizona. But now, even many Democrats are criticizing her for refusing to debate Carrie Lake. And Carrie Lake has made this, right now, the centerpiece of her campaign. I mean, just look at her Twitter feed, right? She calls Hobbs out for this every chance she gets. Here she is.
Why is it that Katie Hobbs will not debate? What is she trying to keep from you? What is she hiding?
The people of Arizona will never support and vote for a coward like Katie Hobbs who won't show up on a debate stage.
I'm doing a debate on Sunday. I'm inviting Katie Hobbs to show up on Sunday. I hope she will. I hope you'll show up. Did somebody say chicken? I didn't say that. Somebody said it.
How much has this refusal to debate hurt Hobbs, Bakari?
Very much so. I mean, it's a bad decision. I don't know who's advising her. I'm pretty sure the DGA. And if the DGA is advising her, then somebody needs to be fired. I mean, it's a terrible decision to make. I mean, you should get on the stage with people who do not deserve to be elected to office. There's no reason why you cannot out-debate Carrie Lake. She stands for nothing. She waffles. She's adiaphorous. She's a fence sitter. I mean, there's nothing she stands for. She does not deserve to represent the citizens of Arizona. And Katie Hobbs needs to stand on stage for an hour or an hour and a half, take the questions, take whatever criticism there is, but blast her opponent and let people know what she stands for and why her opponent does not want to be there. The decision not to debate, me and Eric don't agree on much. In fact, Eric still calls me Bacardi, which we're going to have to deal with later. But the fact is, we do know that, it's okay, I still love you, Eric. We do know that she needs to debate, and that's something we both agree on.
All right, so Eric, you heard what Kyung Lah said about Governor Youngkin. He has had glowing praise for Carrie Lake. He shows up with her on the campaign trail yesterday. Here's what he said.
You need a fighter, and you've got one. That's what you've got. You need a leader who's going to understand that she works for you. And let me tell you, I think you should hire her.
Okay, Eric, here's the thing. The one thing that she really has stood for and been very vocal about, right, one of them nationally, right, has been that she denies the integrity and that the 2020 election, okay? That is something that Glenn Youngkin has vocally been on the other side of. I mean, so he said that about Carrie Lake. You got to hire her. She's so amazing. He's also said these things.
Joe Biden was legitimately elected our president. I mean, he took the oath and was sworn in.
I've said there wasn't material fraud, and I believe that the election was certifiably fair.
So, Eric, how can he back Carrie Lake?
Well, I mean, trying to make politicians consistent over time with what they stand for when they all just want to win is kind of a losing battle here. I mean, to Bakari's point earlier on that Lake isn't fit to serve and she's not qualified and the like, the problem here is I think Democrats really do care about January 6th. They care about the election nihilism. I actually care about it. I think they're wrong and that 2,000 mules nonsense is garbage and left a lot of people in lurch with some madness that needs to be overcome. But at the same time, you've got a really bad economy. You've got all these other issues out there that Republicans have focused on in closing. And voters care way more about the price of gas and groceries than they do the 2020 election, more so than any of us do. And that's what's winning these elections. And Glenn Youngkin wants to be tied to that because that's why he got elected.
Right. And Glenn Youngkin may have much bigger ambitions. So he wants to get everybody
right.
Everybody
Absolutely.
On his side. All right. Thank you both very much.